This conference will now be recorded.
Great. So hi everyone, welcome to this session. This is going to be a quick session where we will just try to understand that what should we be focusing on while studying history from the perspective of GK section of entrance examinations like TIS, IFT or CMAT or so that's what we are going to discuss in this session. And then I'll also be talking about the fact sheets, that which all sections in the fact sheets are must to study, and probably which one or two areas in fact sheets are what you can skip for now. So that's what we are going to discuss in this particular session, so that you can first focus on those subsections of these ebooks which are more important, and the other areas you can leave for the end rather than studying them right now. So that is the purpose of this session. Now, history, if I talk about history, we have provided you three ebooks. We have provided you ancient history, medieval history, and modern Indian history. From exams perspective, medieval history and modern history are the most important ones. Ancient history is least important out of these three. So if you have to start studying, first study medieval history, then study modern history, and then go to ancient history. Or probably ancient history ebook is the one which you could keep for the last as well. It's very rare that questions would come from ancient history. They have come in past, and hence you need to study, but the chance of the question to come from ancient history is rare. So you can focus first on medieval and modern history. Now, talking about which subsections in the modern history ebook are important. Let's see. I'll scroll. This particular section, advent of European commerce, you can leave it. You can leave this entire part. From this table, probably the areas where you need to focus more is, just remember this year, 1600 establishment of English East India Company. Then these, this year is what you need to remember, 1613. You can leave 1608, 1609. Then coming down, you can leave all these areas. These all these years are not important. You can leave them. So majorly from this entire table, 2 years which are most important are 1600 and 1613. Rest, if you can remember, good. If you cannot remember, you can skip. Yes, Khushi, please ask. Then British expansion in India, acquisition of Indian states in British Empire, you should remember these. You should remember these states. Now, when you are studying British conquest of Bengal, you just need to remember the years. Khushi, I am just telling on the basis of the kind of questions which have come in past. That does not mean that something which I am asking you to leave for the end will not come. Again, I'm not asking you to not to study. I'm just saying that this is something which you can study at higher priority, and other areas you can leave for the end. That's what I'm saying. Now, if you are, say, studying about British conquest of Bengal, you should remember the year. You should remember what was the situation, you know, who was the king when the situation got worsened. That's what you need to remember. I'm highlighting those areas so that when you watch the video, you can remember those areas. Then different battles is what you should remember. You should remember the year, and the battle was fought between who all. So Battle of Buxar is an important one, and similarly Battle of Plassey. So you should remember these two battles. Governor generals, you should remember who was the governor general and during which year. And if there was anything important, you don't need to remember all these years for all these governor generals. So you just for Warren Hastings, because he was pretty popular, and hence you need to remember for him. For other governors, just remember anything important which happened during their time. You can leave these years for Lord Cornwallis, for Sir John Short, Lord Wellesley. You can skip the years. Just remember what happened as an important thing during his time. That goes true for all the governor generals. You can leave the years. You don't need to study the years. Similarly, when it comes to Viceroys of India, the most important one is Lord Canning. You should remember Lord Canning. Others you can skip or say keep it for the end. Even if say you don't remember the years, it's completely fine. Lord Curzon is important. Lord Curzon is important. Then your Lord Chelmsford is important. Lord Reading is important. Lord Irwin is what you need to study. Then you can skip. Lord Mountbatten, I don't need to say that this is important. So these are some of the viceroys which you should remember at the higher priority. Others you can skip. Coming to revolt of 1857, very important, try to remember all the important events of 1857. 1857 is an important area, you should remember it. So this much is what you should remember. Coming to the Indian National Movement. Now, talking about Indian National Movement, Indigo Revolt is what you can skip. Remember Indian National Congress, remember Partition of Bengal, important thing. Swadeshi Movement, important. Muslim League, important. Surat Session of INC, important. Gadar Party, you should remember. Lucknow Pact, another important thing. August Declaration. Jallianwala Bagh. Khilafat Movement. The areas which I am not highlighting are the ones which you can leave for the end. What I am highlighting, they are the must to study. Khilafat is what you should know. Non-cooperation movement, important. Chauri Chaura incident, Simon Commission. Yes, Khushi. Any questions, Khushi? Jallianwala Bagh, Khilafat movement, non-cooperation movement, Chauri Chaura incident. To Gadar movement, Gadar party, then Lucknow Pact, then August Declaration. Then coming down to Jallianwala Bagh, Khilafat movement, non-cooperation movement, Chauri Chaura, Simon Commission, Lahore Session, Dandi March, First Roundtable Conference, Gandhi-Irwin Pact, Second Roundtable Conference, Third one, Demand for Pakistan, Revolt of 1942 and Quit India Movement, then the Indian National Army, which was established by Subhash Chandra Bose, remember Jinnah's Direct Action Resolution. And then your formation of Constituent Assembly. These are the topics which you should be studying definitely without fail from the modern history ebook. Is it clear? The other ones you can keep at the lower priority, but these ones are of the higher priority. Any questions? Okay, so now I will move to medieval history. Very important from exam perspective, just like modern history. What all you should remember? Simran, the part which I have not highlighted is what you can keep for the end. In the sense that once you are done with all the important topics and all their important subsections, then you can move to the unhighlighted part. Muhammad Ghazni is what you should remember. Muhammad Ghori. Muhammad Ghazni, Muhammad Ghori are important. Everything which is given about Delhi Sultanate. All these dynasties, Lodi dynasty, Sayyid, Tughlaq, Khijli, Slave, you should study about them. You should know the names of the kings. There is no need to remember the year. No need to remember the year. Just remember the name of the kings. No need to remember the year. And even when it comes to kings, you don't need to remember all the kings. You could just remember the first king and the last king of a particular dynasty. Similarly, Khilji dynasty, you should remember the first name. It was Jalaluddin Khilji, Alauddin Khilji, Mubarak Shah Khilji. They are just three, so you can remember all three. Similarly, for Tughlaq, you should know who was that Ghiyasuddin Tughlaq was the first king. Then it was Muhammad bin Tughlaq. Firoz Shah Tughlaq, just remember the name. And you should remember these kind of things, whatever is bold. That what was Diwan-e-Khairat, what was called Diwan-e-Khairat, you should be able to tell this. You don't need to remember these years, 1335, 1336, 1341, you can skip all it. But remember what was Diwan-e-Khairat. Similarly goes for all the dynasties. You don't need to remember the years. Remember the names of the kings and any important thing which was there about their darbars. So a lot of kings during those times, they used to have different things in their darbars, which were named differently. And that's what you need to remember. Years you can skip. So years are what you can skip. You don't need to remember the years. I guess that would make your life easy. Then similarly, when I'm talking about Sikhism, you should know who was the founder of Sikhism. When it comes to Sikh gurus, remember Guru Nanak. Then any guru for whom you found anything special. So for example, if there is Guru Angad with Janam Sakhi, please remember it. Right, Simran. Now similarly here, if there is something called Anand Karaj, then remember it was by Guru Ram Das. Guru Granth Sahib, remember this Guru Arjun Dev Ji. Others you can skip. Remember Guru Tegh Bahadur, slightly popular. Similarly, Guru Gobind Singh, popular. Others you can remember these six to you know these five Ks. These five Ks are important from Sikh perspective. It could be asked. Mughal rule. Remember the sequence. Remember the sequence. You don't need to remember that Babur was 1483 to 1530. You don't need to remember this. But Babur was where it started, is what you should remember. You should remember the names of the important battles, their years. Battles are important. For the Mughal period, battles are important. You should know all the important battles fought by Babur, their name, their year, and whom did he fight with. This is an important thing. Then architectural development by Babur. You should remember this also. Then Babur was followed by Humayun is what you should remember. You can skip the year. But Babur was followed by Humayu is what you should remember. Then again, the name of Humayu expeditions is what you should remember. Architectural development, once again, important. Architectural developments, name of the battles, and who followed whom is important. Then Humayu was followed by Akbar is what you should remember. Then the different battles fought by Akbar is what you should remember. The political campaigns, etc. This is important. Again, this question can come in the exam. The nine jewels of Akbar's court, you should remember their name. Similarly, architectural development by Akbar, you should remember. Periods, you can skip Deepika, but you should know the sequence. You should know that Babur came first, then Humayu, then Akbar. You can skip remembering the years of Babur, years of Humayu, and years of Akbar. Similarly, these things like Panch Mahal, Diwane Khas, all these are important things you should study. All the architectural developments you should study. Similarly, about Jahangir, again important, you should study. Similarly, the architectural developments by Jahangir. Yes, Vardhan, I'm going to talk about fact sheets also. So architectural development by Jahangir is what you should remember. Similarly for Shahjahan. Aurangzeb, Sher Shah, all are important. This makes these kings as important subjects to study from exam perspective. You should know the sequence, you should know their important things about their courts, architectural developments, and the battles fought. Similarly, when we talk about Marathas, you should know about the names of all the Marathas, Shahaji Bhosle, Shivaji, you should remember all these things. These are important events you should remember. Peshwas, just remember the name of all the Peshwas. You don't need to remember Peshwas in detail. Simran, what they did, you don't need to remember, but you should remember the architectural developments. You should remember the wars they have fought, and you should remember anything special given about their courts. So, for example, Akbar had this nine jewels. You should know that. Then there was one more Mughal king who had Diwane Khas. You should know that. Peshwas, just remember the names and the sequence. Other areas, other details you can skip. The name and the sequence. Then the third battle of Panipat was fought between who all? So this is what you need to remember in medieval history. Important ebook after modern history. Modern history and medieval history are the two most important ebooks. From medieval history, mostly the question is typically asked from Mughals. So Mughal dynasty is the most important dynasty which you should remember about. Coming to ancient history, relatively less important. Stone Age culture, you can skip all this. You can skip this. You don't need to study Stone Age things. Skip this, skip this. Harappan culture is important to study. Read about Harappan culture. The things given about the Stone Age and all before this is what you can skip. Harappan culture is the first thing which you should definitely cover. Indus Valley, remember everything about Indus Valley. Remember about the Vedic literature, all the four Vedas, what is given in what Veda. So Vedas are important. Name of all the Vedas is important. Upanishads is important. Battle name, battle year, where was the battle fought, between whom was the battle fought, and who won it? Smriti literature, you should remember. Deepika, that table of Stone Age and all which is given is what you can leave. They can ask you about the specialties of Indus Valley, any important architectural development, any important name, any important university, etc. Epics. Remember Ramayana Mahabharata. So epics you will remember. Emergence of Mahajan Pradas you can skip. Just remember one thing over here. The name of the Mahajanpads and their capitals. Just remember this much. Rest everything you can skip. For Mahajanpads, just remember the name and their capital. Rest everything you can skip. No. You can skip Alexander invasion, Persian invasion, rise of Magadhas. Study about the Mauryan facts. Mauryan facts important. Then again the sequence of the kings. Know about Chandragupta Maurya, Ashoka facts. So Chandragupta and Ashoka are important to study. India after Mauryas, you can leave. All this part you can leave. You can leave. Again, you can leave. Just remember this table. Just remember this table. This table is what you should remember. Cholas, you can leave. Pandyas, Cheras, you can leave. Age of Guptas, you can leave. Again, in Age of Guptas, just remember the sequence. Chandragupta I, then Samudgupta. You should know the sequence. That's it. Other parts you can skip. Again, anything important about the Gupta architecture, remember it. Ajanta paintings important. Remember. And then just read a bit about the Rajput ruling dynasties. That's it. That's it. So that's about the ancient history ebook. A good part of ancient history ebook is what you can leave. Is it clear? Is it clear what all to study from the three ebooks of history? Perfect. Moving to the fact sheet. Now, see, we give you a lot of areas to study in fact sheets, but there are some topics from which questions are generally not asked in exam, or say very rarely asked. You can skip it. The national subsection in the ebook is important solely from current affairs perspective. More than this, national subsection will be asked in your IFT, ZAT and CMAT examinations. Sandeep, you can skip this. So national subsection of the fact sheet is what you should remember. International is what you can skip. This section is what you can skip because international is asked very, very rarely. You can skip international. You can skip international subsection of the fact sheet. Sports is important. Every exam, whether it be TIS, IFD, ZAT or CMAT is going to ask you sports question in the GK section. Sports is very important. Sports question are generally asked like who won a particular tournament, when was the tournament held, where was the tournament held, who were the different teams participating or different countries participating in countries or in type of questions around Olympics, Asian Games, etc. They may ask you that which country won the highest number of medals, where was India, how much did India win, and then the name of the top athletes, the top sport awards is what they can ask you. So sports is an important subsection. Again, when you are studying about sports, remember, focus more on the winners, their names, their countries, the year, and the venue of the tournament. National subsection is less important for TIS, more important for IFT and ZAT. But sports section is very important for all the examinations. International is what only IFT people need to study. ZAT, TISnet people can skip international subsection. Only for IFT people, international subsection is important. This is a very important subsection, business and economy, especially for people who are going to appear for HRM and ODCL in TISnet. This subsection will have questions coming from it in TISmat paper, which is mandatory for HRM and ODCL. So business and economy is an important subsection of the ebook for TISmat paper. Similarly, it is very important for IFT people. Similarly, it is very important for ZAT people. So business and economy is what you can afford to study at the end only if you are aiming for non-HRM and non-ODCL courses at TIS. But if HRM or ODCL is your aim, business and economy is an important subsection. And for IFT also, business and economy is very important. Vardhan, for TISnet, yes, you can leave international. Awards, yes, for TISnet, business and economy, as I said, because if you are aiming for HRM and ODCL, it will be asked in the TISmat paper. And even in TISnet, they will ask you one or two questions from business and economy. In TISmat, they will ask you 4 to 5 questions from business and economy. Awards and honors, very important for every exam. Awards and honors, very important for every exam. You can skip entertainment and miscellaneous. You can skip entertainment and miscellaneous. You can skip entertainment and miscellaneous. Appointments, important. Appointments are important for every exam. Appointments are important. Defense, science and technology, you can skip. Defense, science and technology, you can skip or say keep for the end. Defense, science and technology is not that important. Reports and rankings, very important for both TIS and IFT. Reports and rankings are very important. Obituaries, leave it. Obituaries, you can leave. Books and authors, very important for all the exams. Summit and conferences, important for TISnet and IFT. Q Khushi, you should start studying from April onwards. April fact sheet onwards. January, February, March will hardly be asked. You should start studying fact sheets from April onwards. Important days. They are important. That's why they are called important days. What? Why is this day celebrated? You don't need to remember. Just remember the heading 7 July World Chocolate Day. So point is just remember the day and the date. This description given is what you should not remember. It's completely fine. That description will not be asked. That is for your understanding perspective. Otherwise, from exam perspective, only the date and the day is important. This description is what you can entirely skip. You can entirely skip. Just remember the date and the day. So, for example, if population day is there, yes, remember the theme. But the other description is what you can skip. Perfect. So, with this, these are some of the subsections of the fact sheet which are important and must to study. Some sections which you can skip, and some sections which need to be studied only for a particular examination. Does this help you? Summit and conference is important, Soumya, both for IIFT and TISTNET. Great. So thank you everyone for attending this session. I hope I could give you some idea that what to study, what not to. Yes, Shagun, this video I will be providing you in the dashboard, as well as I'm going to upload it on YouTube and share it with all of you within next 20 minutes. Great, perfect. Thank you everyone. Keep studying hard. I'm pretty sure all of you are going to do well in the examination. In case of any doubts, any help needed at any point of time, I'm just a WhatsApp message away. Thank you everyone. Thank you, Soumya. Good night. Good night, everyone.